Welcome back to Pokémon Master EX. We are here indeed for a very special follow-up occasion to a very recent event, honestly. I don't really think that it has been 3 or 4 months, like even less, maybe. I don't remember when it was. But we have a follow-up to the Isui first event that had Adamant and Dirida with a new one that now has Rei and Akari, as you can see on the background right there. We have also Nemona, which I will showcase on. I know that I'm a little bit behind with the showcases. It has been a very busy time, and I want to catch up for sure with Pokémon Master EX. But we are here with a very exciting event and also a very exciting update because they added, finally, I might add, because I really wanted them to expand it a lot, a skill equipment. So let me show you guys this first since we get it out of the way. So if you go to gear now, you have type gear and skill gear. What is a skill gear? Basically, it is an equipment that is based on teams. So ice, the team where the character is from, their accessories and stuff like that. And it gives some specific buffs. In this case, my first equipment gives Dragon P Move DR and Smooth DR damage reduction. And Bug P Move DR and Smooth DR also damage reduction. Obviously, you will have to unlock a lot of different types of upgrades that will be exciting or not, depending if you get lucky or not. By this, a cool direction to take in for the equipment, which finally gets a real usage. What we had before was just a stat boost, now we finally get into the juicy parts with some skill usage as well, that I really like. You can unlock the equipment by doing the new daily quest event that will give you some free skill equipment. You need those feathers to unlock the skills themselves. So make sure to play a lot to get the feathers because probably that will be the next resource that you want. I've seen a lot of people that are questioning why they're adding so many new things to the game. We have the new roll cakes, we have the new feathers and equipment. I will say I do like it because it adds a layer of depth into the game, but I do understand that it makes the game a little bit more hard to approach to for new players. Like a new player has to deal with EX, the tickets to upgrade to 5 stars, equipment, skill equipment, the roll cakes, and also the fact that there are a lot of limited characters in the game. Honestly, the more you go onwards with the gacha, the more this happens. It is not something relegated to Pokémon Master EX. For someone that has a gacha channel, I can guarantee you that it is something that happens a lot. Basically, the devs reach a point where the game probably has gone past its intended course, and now they wonder what do we do to continue, and they throw darts at a wall to get some new ideas. In this case, I do like them myself because I do play the game a lot off video, of course, and I do think that it is a cool way to add a layer of depth into the gameplay and make it so you can make harder content for veterans. But gacha games need to attract new players, and I hope that in the future they will try to renovate the new player experience because it needs to be streamlined a little bit. Like, if you open the gacha, now I'm not really sure if it is still like that. But we had like 28 gacha banners. Okay, no, right now we don't. A week ago we had 28 gacha banners. That's a lot for a new player. You don't really need to overcrowd the gacha banner like that because at that point you don't really understand what you want to get. Like, there are many characters in this game, many types, which is also another negative in a way because you also need to have many different teams now for each type. So try to streamline it a bit, that's the suggestion I can give. And also, immediately plan the next main story. Main story is the best way to tell your players that the game is still on and you want it to survive. And I do think that they are doing it with the new Isui events, but I'm not really sure. We will see if that's the case. Probably we will see 2 or 3 more months of new characters from Isui and Paldea, and then probably the main story will resume. That's what I'm guessing. But anyway, we are here for Akari. Akari is the character that is from Isui. Rei is the character that is from Sinnoh. If you guys know the story of Legend Arceus, you know what I mean. Rei is the main character. So in this case, I want to get Akari because I love the Isuians. And while I would also welcome to get Rei, I actually only have 9k gems. Why? Because I went all in for the champion Leaf. I had 2 Sparker, much like Lily before her in the second anniversary, and so I was out of gems. They are reducing the gems amount every month, so It is getting a little bit tougher to be free to player, so this month I will probably only do those 11 rolls actually, and then I will wait until November to continue rolling. We do have a lot of backlog of showcases, so do not worry. Probably I will use that time to catch up, but for the gacha you guys will probably have to wait until November to see something new. But I have seen that probably there isn't really anything that I really care for the rest of the month, like I'm fine with getting just a Gary if we get her. Also worth to note, finally, we have the presents that include the Roll Cakes coins. This is actually something that I wanted to see, because I can unlock the roll for Akari, I think. I have 14, 18, 2 off, but should be close enough to where I can unlock it fairly soon. So anyway, let's see if we can get her. As usual, she has a very unique model that reflects Legend Arceus. I really recommend to play it if you guys can catch it on the Switch, one of my favorite games from last year. It was, I believe it was last year. But anyway, let's get into it. So she's a dark type. Actually a very good dark type. I believe that she's a field, if I'm not wrong. So you can't really unlock her with the candies, which is another thing that adds to the layer of difficulty that they gave to new players and veterans bot, because now you need to farm the field and which is the sprint, which is kinda a little bit annoying, I will admit, but I do have one general coin for Akari. Probably I want to save it for Iono, because I am fairly sure that Iono is going to be either field or sprint as well, because she will be electric, and electric is filled with really good sync pairs, to the point that truly I don't really see how she's going to be effective unless she's a niche. They are doing this damage field kind of a new thing where you see it with Leon. Basically they add a field that every time the opponent attacks they get damaged by the type of which the field is, in this case dark type for Akari. It is actually a very good effect. I've used it with Leon and it has a lot of merit to it. If you get Akari, hopefully in this last pool, I would love to show it to you guys in our showcase. Ok, Pokéfair 211 pulls got nodding. That's actually the first time I've been this unlucky in a Pokéfair. So, come on, let's pray together that this one is it. Please, 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 Akari, come home, please. Ok, we start very good with a special animation. But I do want to see if it is Akari or not, because last time we did this with Leaf, it went all wrong, to be honest. It was such a bad gacha. Like, I expected to get Leaf and someone else, but I got nodding. Nodding at all. Ok, 3, 4, 5, 6. How many times have I gotten Elisa in pools? I have no idea. I've gotten like 100 Elisas. Doesn't look like we're going to get Akari, does it? Last one, please? No. Oh, wasn't even the last one. Ok, terrible. Terrible, 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 terrible. I will probably keep rolling off video for her at this point, because, like, at least I will get those cakes. Wait. Let me see. I actually have rolled, so technically I should get the cakes, no? Is that only for the paid one? Maybe this only for the paid one, or maybe this for... Well, who knows? I am just saddened that every time it goes bad whenever I get past the anniversary. But it is what it is. It is the joy on brackets of the gacha, and I have to tolerate it. But I will get Akari for sure. The month is still long, she runs through the whole month. This was just a video to let you guys know that they are here, Akari and Rei from Legends Arceus. And be sure to get them, because they are Pokéfair, so limited. I do suggest to get Akari over Rei, because I do think that Fire is a little bit overcrowded, and Dark can use what Akari does really well, but that's up to you, honestly. We'll do the showcase whenever I get Akari, so you guys will know better about what she does. And also, obviously, the event coming very soon. Not sure if today or tomorrow, but probably today, honestly. I don't really have anything else planned for today, from what I remember. Want to do the EX unlock because I need the Champion Spirits, but I will say this. Nemona, Champion Leaf, Gloria, Leon, I have a lot of showcases in the backlog. So I will try and make sure to get some of those out. But for today this is it. Thank you much for watching as usual. Remember to like and sub, support the channel. And if you want to support the channel more, remember to use the Super Thanks feature to leave a comment to mention your choosing below your favorite Pokémon Master EX video. bye my friends, and hopefully you have better luck than mine. Honestly, not that hard.